If someone hacks my Gmail, can they hack my other accounts? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Ask Leo is supported in part by my patrons, for whom I'm very, very thankful. Visit askleo.com/patron for more information about supporting Ask Leo and patron exclusive benefits. Here's the question. If someone has one password to my Gmail account, can they access my other account even though it has a different email and password? The best I can say is maybe, but this is something that I think people overlook a lot. And as a result, I want to go over the scenarios that we're talking about. So the initial compromise here is that someone has a password for your Gmail account. In other words, they can log into your Gmail. They can obviously change the password, but if you can still get in, perhaps they haven't. They can read your email. They can do a number of interesting things. The interesting things part is worth paying attention to. For example, after they read a message, they get into your account, and after they read one of your emails, they could mark it as unread. Unless you were looking at the exact same time, you would never know that they had read it. They could take one of the messages that you've received, forward it to somewhere else, and then delete the forward from your sent mail, and again, make it marked as unread. You might not notice that it had been forwarded if you weren't paying attention. Perhaps worst of all, they could receive a message, read it, delete it, and remove it from your trash. You'll see why that's worst of all here in a moment. But while they have access to your account, they can cause a lot of havoc, even without denying you access to the account. Here's the scenario. What I'll call directly linked accounts are accounts for which you have used this Gmail email address as either the login ID or a recovery ID. I'll talk about recovery IDs later. Let's talk about the login ID first. They don't have access to this other account yet, but they have access to your Gmail account. Maybe they can see from your email that, oh, you've got a Dropbox account because there's a message from Dropbox for you. Great. They can then run over to the Dropbox account, try to log in. Of course, it will fail because they don't know your password. They will then initiate a password reset. Click on I forgot my password. Dropbox will then send you, your email address, a password reset request. They, since they have access to your email, can read it, act on it, reset your Dropbox password, and then delete the email from your Gmail as if it had never arrived. They now have access to your Dropbox. They have set a new password on your Dropbox. You don't have access to your Dropbox. And to be super, super clear, Dropbox is just an example. Any other service that you use this Gmail account to log in is vulnerable if they have access to your Gmail account. They don't really even need to know that those other accounts exist, right? In my case, my example here, I told you that they happen to notice you've got a Dropbox account because you received some email from Dropbox. The other scenario that is probably more common is that they'll just try all the popular services. They'll run password reset requests against Dropbox and OneDrive and all, just any other online service you can think of. Chances are you'll probably use one of them. That password reset request will work. They will see the email show up in your inbox. They'll act on it. They will compromise that other service, and they'll delete the email from your inbox as if it never showed up. So, yes, they can get directly linked accounts. Now, I truly realize that that was not your question. You were very specific about how this email address was not used to log into this other account. That's great. But what if it's your recovery address? What if that email address, your Gmail address that they have access to because they know the password? What if that's the account not to log into that service, but to recover the account for that service? It's the secondary email address or an alternate email address for these other services. Everything I've just talked about works pretty much the same. They can try, and they do try, your Gmail account against all of these other services in the hopes of trying to reset your password. It gets worse. Let's say you don't use your Gmail account as the secondary email address for any of these other accounts, except for one. Let's say you have a second email address. I'll just say a Yahoo address. And that's what you're using for all of these other accounts. From your perspective, you've got your Gmail account as being completely separate from all these other accounts because they use your Yahoo account. What's the recovery email address for your Yahoo account? If it's your Gmail, you've still created a link. You've still created a stepping stone. They could compromise your Gmail account, use that to then compromise your Yahoo account, and use that then to compromise all of these other accounts that you happen to use your Yahoo email address to sign in. What can I say? Do they do it really? We've heard of this kind of stuff happening, but it's not particularly common. Not yet, anyway. That doesn't mean it can't happen to you. You need to stay secure. And ultimately, there's nothing special about this scenario. You don't need to take extra steps. You need to take the steps we keep recommending you take all the time. Use strong passwords. Use different passwords on every site or service. Use a password vault to make those two steps easy. Keep your account recovery information up to date on all of those accounts. And if you can, use two-factor authentication. Because that way, the very first question you started with is a non-starter. Even if someone had the password to your Gmail account, if you have two-factor authentication on that Gmail account, they still can't get in. Hope that helps. Hope that helped clarify a little bit about why security is so incredibly important. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/146153. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.